Touchdown confirmed. Perseverance safely on the surface of Mars.
Just a couple of days ago, NASA was able to land their newest rover on the surface of Mars. And a couple of days later, we received the first video ever of a landing on another planet. This is wild, close to science fiction. It is even more incredible if you take into account the million things that had to work exactly as intended to make this possible. And also, the other billion that could have gone wrong. Rocket explosions, bad turns, bad math, and disastrous crashes. All these things could have happened. Landing on Mars is no easy task. So, without further ado, here is why it's so difficult to land on Mars. But first, let's look at some of the things we need before leaving our beautiful blue dot. To begin, we cannot just shoot a rocket and follow a map to Mars. No, it's a little more complicated than that. But just a little. What we need to do is track where Mars is relative to Earth, so we can plan exactly when to launch our rocket. This is a little tricky, because Mars takes 1.88 years to go around the Sun, and it's not like we're just waiting for it to do so, we're also following our own orbit. And the best time to launch a rocket, what we call the launch window, is when both planets are about to be at their closest distance. This event is called opposition, and it takes place every 26 months. It's named like that because the Sun and Mars are on opposite sides of Earth. And I say about to be because, thanks to orbital mechanics, we also can't just shoot rockets in a straight line when opposition occurs. But we need to calculate an orbit to be able to transfer our rocket from Earth's orbit to Mars, which presents its own challenges. Because, you see, Mars's orbit is more elliptical than Earth's, and it's also more tilted. It has an almost 2-degree inclination. And these are just some of the things we need to consider to be able to plot our course through space and arrive at Mars. So let's assume we have done all the math, we have plotted a course from Earth to Mars, taking all variables into account, and our launch window is approaching. Now we need a rocket.
And the motors of each section.
And getting a rocket is no easy task, it's literal rocket science. They take years to develop and cost millions and billions of dollars. It involves economic incentives, politics, government and private agendas, and many other factors that have nothing to do with going to space.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
Imagine having all the science and engineering ready, and then the government changes its agenda and cuts funding to your space adventures. Or your company runs out of money, and you cannot find any investors willing to drop $500 million in space exploration development. So, before we have our rocket, we already have a ton of headaches and obstacles. Just for the sake of argument, let's assume everything runs nice and smooth, and we have our rocket ready to depart to Mars. There's the real possibility that, even after all that hassle, it explodes and destroys everything inside. Since the inception of space exploration, 8.08% of unmanned rockets have failed and gone in a fiery display. If we take into account just the last 20 years, it decreases a little to 6.68%. That's still almost a 7% chance of a couple billion dollars going aflame in seconds. Man, we haven't even left Earth and this still looks like an impossible endeavor. But it doesn't matter, because our rocket ended up being made and it didn't explode. It took off and is en route to Mars. Or at least the capsule is. The rocket is only needed to leave the atmosphere and as an initial boost. Assuming we didn't deviate from our path and we arrived at the precise time and location where Mars is, we now have the most difficult task as of yet. Landing. Because as much as Mars may look a lot like Earth in some pictures, it's not so much in reality. To begin, Mars's atmosphere is almost non-existent, having less than 1% of Earth's, and that makes slowing down incredibly difficult. Oh, but there is an atmosphere, don't get me wrong, just enough to be a pain in the ass and burn you if you're not in the right angle, but not enough to help you decelerate. And that's been a problem in the past, as many missions have ended up splattered all over the Martian surface. And to make things worse, we on Earth cannot assist in any way, shape or form, because thanks to the great distance, there is almost a 12-minute delay in communications. That sure looks like a lot of trouble. But we have landed successfully in the past. I mean, we just did a couple of weeks ago. So, how did we do it? Well, we have to go from 13,000 miles per hour to zero in 7 minutes. This is sometimes referred to as the 7 minutes of terror, because everything can go wrong here. The descent has to be performed automatically by the lander, and it involves many stages using parachutes, radar, rockets, and in some cases in the past, inflatable airbags. It doesn't matter if we crash or land, by the time we receive a signal, the lander's fate would have been decided 12 minutes prior. Assuming we landed, now on Mars, our rover has to face many other challenges, like not freezing to death, as temperatures can get to negative 73 C or negative 100 F for our Imperial friends. That's why rovers have an integrated heating system, because otherwise they wouldn't be able to function properly. So imagine having gone through all that trouble. Doing the math, having the rocket, shooting the rocket, getting to Mars, being able to land on Mars, just to have the rover's heating system malfunction. Yeah. Thankfully, the people at NASA and their partners are extremely capable, and none of those things happened. Perseverance marks the fifth successful rover landing by NASA, so I'm very confident when I say that they know their stuff. People there have dedicated their lives to be able to create ingenious solutions to all the challenges presented by Mars. Yes, it's really hard to land on Mars, but this achievement is just a little demonstration of what we can achieve when we work together towards a single goal. Not even space or another planet were enough to stop humanity's perseverance, and that is why it's so difficult, but not impossible, to land on Mars. I really hope that you enjoyed that video. Do not forget to destroy the like button and subscribe if you did. Follow me on social media for more things and a little behind the scenes for when I'm making these videos. I upload every 2 weeks, and if you haven't seen my other videos, please do. You can watch the evolution of Santa Claus, the history of coffee, the story behind Einstein's biggest failure, and so on. I'm pretty sure you'll find something you like. I really hope to see you on the next one. Have a nice day, or night, and goodbye.